WDNC first warning weather. Things couldn't be prettier here. Look at our Gulfport Island View Casino cam. Great sunset tonight. But of course, a little bit upset about what's going to happen with this here. This is going to be a big problem in Florida here. Let's check out the latest stats. Category 5 hurricane right now. If you didn't hear, made a Category 5 yesterday. Barometric pressure was all the way down below 900 millibars. Some of the lowest pressure of any storm ever in the Gulf. Then back up to a Category 5 today. Maintaining strength, at least maximum sustained winds at 165. Again, that's at wind speed averaged over a minute. Gusts can be even higher than there. But we are expecting the storm to hit some wind shear and hit a weakening process. I'd love to see it weaken a lot more than this. It will expand in size, however, making landfall as a Category 3. That's still a major hurricane overnight Wednesday into Thursday, still maintaining hurricane status all the way through the Florida Peninsula. When you look at the satellite imagery, it's really been impressive. The storm in size has actually been not that big. You can see it cycling through over the last 12 hours. Take a look at the visible satellite imagery from earlier today, and that visible satellite imagery. We'll just look at the symmetry, look at the cloud tops, the well-defined eye wall that's here. So something that devastating still has an aspect to it. Drawn tons of humidity. Unfortunately, you look at that, tons of humidity is going to drop tons of rain. Tampa, Orlando, Ocala in here, Gainesville here too. And there's a risk for severe storms on top of the devastating winds and storm surge. Look at the wind swath and the timing by this particular forecast. Landfall by about 11. Now that's our time, so that's about midnight their time. And it will be drawing up some really, really extreme storm surge, up to possibly 18 feet. And the bullseye, unfortunately, is in one of the largest cities within Florida at Tampa. And then coming through Tampa and hitting Orlando here, too, you don't have to worry about storm surge, obviously, but we'll be watching those winds. I mentioned the size of this storm as well. It is pretty compact right now. We've got the hurricane force winds are only extending out about 30 miles and tropical storm force winds at about 140 miles. But look at the expansion the storm will undergo tomorrow. Possibly tropical storm force winds hitting the west coast by early afternoon. The hurricane force winds you can see here shown in the red where the worst will be, right in through Tampa, just skirting Orlando, thinking that's more tropical storm status winds. Tons of rainfall, wide swaths of 5 to 12, maybe 1.5 feet in some areas. Flood watch is obviously in effect. And here's one of the highest resolution forecasts that I can give the timing, almost exactly with the other forecast too. And it shows it a little farther north than the official track. We're not getting the storm out of here till we get to Thursday night.